with a quick reminder of what our expectations are at Elmwood School when we're in a meeting. So this is a biggie, right? We have lots to do, and we don't really have that much time to get it all done, so we need to get going. I want all the eagles to sit on their bottom and crisscross their legs, please. I want your eyes up front. We're going to have some folks coming up front, and we have a wonderful orchestra behind us. And we need to be really, really respectful. And that means being a good listener and a good audience. So I'm just going to take a quick look. I'm going to start at the left and go across and see what I see, if kids are being a good audience. Perfect, and we're going to stay this way with this kind of self-control. So I'm so excited. I want to welcome our adult visitors to the meeting of the Eagles, and I'm glad that you can be here. We're going to start, as we start all things in a group like this, with the Pledge of Allegiance. Mrs. Lab's class is going to lead us, and Isabel Walker and Sophia Castanier are going to lead the pledge up front, so come on up.
Alakia, Aruni, Vishnu, Akshu, Enzo, Allie, Owen, Andrew, Brady, Anna. Okay. Boys and girls, we're gonna go ahead and sing Bandicoot next. Let's go and try it together. Hey, third graders, playing position first note, ready? Let's try one more time. Let's wait until it's entirely quiet so we can start our song together.
You can't see. I'll be the light to guide you. to thank this class because they're amazing, but I also want to thank all of you. There was a video that was supposed to play, and the technology was not working. And I did not expect to play the ukulele without the video. So I got really, really nervous and probably made a million mistakes, but you guys were such an incredible audience, so you should know that I've never played the ukulele in front of anybody. So thank you for being so awesome. That was not supposed to happen. Thank you.
So the neat thing about meeting up the Eagles is people will ask you, what is it? And it's not a thing. It's something that you feel in your heart, really. And that was an amazing example of that. So thank you. Thank you very much. Next, what do we have next?
Boys and girls, so we're going to go ahead and sing What a Wonderful World next.
Thank you.
championship of March Madness.
And I'm the first female finisher of the Boston Marathon. finish line, I mean, that for a lot of people is the culmination of their dreams and their training. Sometimes I'm in tears watching these people come in. Well, I first saw the Boston Marathon in 1964, and I fell in love with it, because I thought, once they know the women can run, the race will open up. As the men's race was about to start, waited in the bushes for a few minutes, and I jumped in. And to my great relief, the men loved it. The men said, we won't let them throw you. They turned on the Boston State, and a huge roar went up from the crowds, went down, crossed the finish line, and I just had such a sense of elation that I had done what I set out to do, and I was making a social statement. Like, I really felt like this was a pivotal moment, and it was going to change how things are for women. And it was just this incredible sense of triumph. I'm Bob Lillian, and I'm the first.
Sorry. All right, so here we are with the final vote. The Charlotte versus the new man. Now I want to share one quick tidbit before we reveal the winner. This was such a close vote. There were 23 classrooms that voted. 11 classrooms picked one book, 12 classrooms voted the other book. That's how close this race was. So, I don't see there are any winners and losers here. I think we got to know two fabulous women. We read two amazing books, and votes do count, so there was one that got the edge here. We're gonna get ready to reveal the winner. You need to stay on your bottoms. Check yourself.
About the boats. I don't know how I got the last on the schedule, but tough acts to follow. I'm going to talk very quickly about my very favorite athlete, and I hope you have just 5 minutes to listen. When I was in third grade, like you, my favorite athlete was a Boston Celtic player named Larry Bird. My son is in third grade now. His favorite player is Jason Tatum, because that, my family was lucky enough to win a contest last year, and we had a barbecue with Jason Tatum at our house, which has nothing to do with what I'm going to talk about today, but it's still fun to say. But my favorite athlete is someone that spoke here last year, and his name is Wesley Carrier. So the third graders remember Wesley Carrier. If everybody could just listen just quickly, a bit quiet just for a minute, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about Wesley Carrier, and then we'll do Coming and Going in the Rain, and it'll be time to go home. Wesley Carrier was born in a poverty-stricken of Africa in western Kenya, and when he was a boy, he had to travel 5 miles, run 5 miles back and forth to school, which is something that is not uncommon in Africa. And in Kenya, preschool and high school is not paid for. So you have to pay to go to high school. And when Wesley became high school age, there was an Irish priest who gave him an opportunity and paid for him to go to high school. And then he did so well in high school that he came to America. He became a wonderful track star for the NCAAs and won championships. And when he was here in college, he said that he would never go back to Kenya because he's now in a land where there's lots of money and he'll never go back to the poverty land. In 2012, he won the Boston Marathon, and leading up to the marathon, he knew that he had a higher calling than just running. And what he did was he went back to Kenya and he ran for office, and he became a member of the Kenyan Parliament. And now he works to change his area of the world. And Elmwood School has done a great job over the last 5 years of helping him out. With the book challenge, we read a wonderful book about Malala, and it's called Malala's Magic Pencil. It was about a little girl who was trying to get girls in Pakistan the opportunity to go to school. Well, in Kenya, Wesley Carrier is working extremely hard to do the same so that Kenyan boys and girls can go to school. And we've done a great job of raising money for him over the years. And if anybody remembers him speaking last year, he spoke eloquently about how we're all connected and we're all our brother's keepers. So I hope you take that to heart, and I hope that we do another great job of raising money this year for the Kenyan Kids Foundation. A letter went home on Monday through email. Kids are welcome to bring in money of any amount. You can also write checks to the Kenyan Kids Foundation. You can also donate online directly to the Kenyan Kids Foundation. So their motto is, for together with the little we can afford, we can change the world. So I hope that everybody really does take it to heart and realize that if you're in a position to give to others, it's really a wonderful thing to do so. I'm gonna end by showing you a 1 minute video clip of a nursery school. And the money that we send to the Kenyan Kids Foundation is earmarked for preschool and nursery school. So this would be an example of the type of community that we're helping. And their accents are heavy, so you might not be able to make out what they're saying, but it starts with an introduction from the nursery school teacher. And it costs $500 a year, and some of our donations go to that to pay for our nursery school teacher. It's $350 per year for a high school student to go to school. In this video, you'll see the Kenyan kids, they're saying, they start with Kenya's foundation, and then they say education, education, education. What is education? Education is the key to success. So I'm just gonna end with this 1 minute video, and I hope that we have another great year of raising money for the Kenyan Kids Foundation. Thank you.
Teacher, and my name is Cynthia Adoni.